What's up, guys? So I'm going to be working on a kind of a abstract landscape today. I want to take a break from the figures that I've been doing and give a shot at some abstract landscape. And I have a few reference photos that I'm going to be using from a hike I went on in Big Bend last year. So let's see if you can see that. This is at, I believe it's called Balance Rock. It was a view through Balance Rock here. And so I have two images there that I'm going to use and see what I can come up with. And I'm gonna make this as abstract as possible, but still hopefully it'll do the photos some justice and still look like a landscape. So we'll see. I'm gonna start off with some charcoal. General's charcoal is what I usually use. I have some vine charcoal. I'll do the sketch with that first. And after that, I'll start playing around with some acrylic paint, lay down some acrylic paint. I'm gonna apply some gesso to this Arches watercolor paper first, and then I'll get started after that. I always coat my watercolor paper with some gesso. I lay it on with the palette knife, then I'll get a brush and just brush it all over the paper. And I'll let this dry for several hours. For this particular one, I let it dry overnight. Came back to it the next day and started my painting. So you can see I use a charcoal pencil. I'm using General's charcoal. That's the charcoal that I prefer to use. I also use some willow charcoal a lot to do the sketches. And you'll see in the beginning, I just do a rough sketch of the idea I have. I'm looking at a reference photo on my iPad Pro in the back there. And I just take this reference photo and just do a real rough sketch and just get the major shapes in there. And then you'll see I'll get started with some paint and start laying the acrylic down. I do kind of a light wash of the acrylic. I use a little bit of water to thin the acrylic down. It's almost kind of like watercolors, I guess. So if you want to give it a try, if you like watercolors, I think you'll like acrylics. They dry rather quickly, though. That's why a lot of people prefer oils over acrylics, because oils take a very long time to dry. For an oil painting, you have to wait 6 months to a year before it's completely dry. For acrylic, it dries pretty fast. You know, it's ready to go overnight. It's completely dry, especially within a few hours. If the paint's not that thick, it'll dry right away. So you can see here, I just lay on some light washes here. I put some color down, just the undertones there. I always like to put the undertones down, and I then slowly build up the layers. I use I have a bottle of alcohol that I use that you see me spray throughout this video, and I'll spray it down and use my palette knife to scrape some of the paint up to create some texture. I'll use a sponge to scrape some of the paint up, and as I build up the layers and I use that alcohol to remove some layers, you see the colors underneath start to show through. So this is a real important step. The colors that I put down a lot of times do not show through until after I start removing some layers. And then in the end, I'm going to finish it off with some charcoal. I love to sketch with charcoal in my paintings. It just adds this element that I enjoy. And I also get the palette knife, get the alcohol, scrape away, add some charcoal in there. And then I almost forgot at the end of this painting, I thought it was done, and then I remembered that I had ordered some oil sticks. They're the Shiva oil stick, Shiva brand. And this is the first time that I use oil sticks, and I'll tell you what, I love them. I'm going to be using these in my paintings quite a bit. It adds some nice thick texture. That's the great thing about oils. You can do it with acrylics too if you build up your layers, but those oil sticks I enjoyed a whole lot, and you're going to see me using those quite a bit. Now, you want to make sure that if you use oil sticks, you want to put your acrylic paint down first, make sure it's dry, then come back, and you can paint oil over acrylic, but you do not want to paint acrylic over oil because it's eventually it's going to flake off. It's not going to have anything to adhere to. So if you want to give some oil sticks a try, try out the Shiva brand. I got them on Amazon. They were fairly inexpensive. There's some other great ones too. I've never used any other ones, so I can't compare them to any others, but I know I like these. So I'm going to stick with these for the price. They were great. I'll put the link in my profile and in case anybody's interested in purchasing those. I use the Lukas Cryl Studio acrylic paints. I've been sticking with those. I enjoy them a lot. I like their watercolor paints. So that's what I stick with, and I enjoy them. I'll be using them for a while, and you know, I have no need to switch. You get a lot of paint for the money, and like I said, I use charcoal, willow charcoal. A lot of time I just get my willow charcoal from Michael's or Hobby Lobby, but I do use, when it comes to the charcoal pencils, I usually use the General's charcoal pencils. Those are my favorite. Always have been. I've been using them since I was a kid, and I just stick with them. So I hope you enjoy this painting. If you have any questions, leave me a comment. And if you could hit that subscribe button, you know, YouTube has changed some of their rules. And so now you got to have 1,000 subscribers and 40,000 watch hours. And I'm nowhere near there. I'm still fairly new to YouTube. So I'm trying to get as many subscribers as I can. So if you want to see more stuff like this, subscribe, share, like the videos, and just keep in touch. Leave some comments, and I'll be happy to answer any questions you might have. Enjoy the video.
Thank you.